You know how I feel.
I met my brothers, and I do this stream outdoors, and I had been checking the weather all day, as you would, and headed over here and started setting up and heard a crack of thunder and then checked the weather and suddenly it was like supposed to be a thunderstorm. And it was like a thunderstorm warning and everything because they get intense around here. So I pulled everything in and started setting up, and of course it only rained for about 3 minutes and now it's gorgeous out there. And then inside in here I kept tripping the breaker, and then for whatever reason, if you were here on the first stream, every time I pressed a key on my keyboard it would send a gazillion numbers onto the screen. So this has been wild. So here's what I want to say. I'm getting to the point where doing this remotely has just become so challenging that I don't know how much longer I can keep doing it. I want to have class on Thursday, and I'm thinking about doing a Zoom class to take advantage of my brother's internet. But after that, if I don't have internet at home still, we might adjust the schedule of these or something. But it's just, and I know that y'all are so supportive and you are so great and no one's asking me to do this. People that know me personally know that like I am tenacious and so I hate canceling class, but it's just getting to the point like where just so much crazy shit is happening that it's just really hard, y'all. And it's really hard after going through the whole experience of, you know, what the hell-ness, to then turn on and teach. And y'all have been so awesome. This is not like me, like, guilt-tripping anybody. Like, I hope you could feel what I'm trying to do, like, right now. It's just like, it's getting to the point where I don't think I can be the best teacher I can because it's so hard to do this remotely. So, I really appreciate y'all sticking with me. Ironically, the views are up since I've been doing it remotely, so that really feels good to me and those of you watching on replay. But let's just, so Thursday, we're going to have a Zoom class. I'm going to have it streaming to, like, I think I will have enough internet space that I can actually stream it to, like, a regular class, but then also have, on another camera, have the Zoom going. So that will be next week. So yeah, no need to feel sorry for me. I just want you to understand that y'all, I think of this like a live class, like an in-person class, and so not doing it, if it feels weird to me, right? Like it, like I get a lot out of teaching, so I just want to make sure that I'm okay. So let's go ahead and jump in. Okay, we're going to do a little breathing, and then we will get started. Hey. Oh, hold on, it's okay. Nobody freak, it's all good. There we go, okay. All right, let's connect. Let's connect. I could use some long distance connection with you guys. Hopefully, okay, hopefully this balance is okay. I think it is. Let's see, we're gonna get feedback. 1, 2. Okay. Audible breath in. Talks about your personal practice, and he really means your yoga practice or your meditative practice, your hoop practice. And essentially, if I'm remembering him right, he sort of says you're in your reality, and that's a room. And you build a second room called your practice. And you put an iron door between the two rooms. There is your reality room, your day-to-day room, and your practice room. And then as you deepen in your practice, you replace the iron door with just an old, sturdy wooden door. And then as your practice deepens, you replace that wooden door with a beaded curtain. And then you just remove all the doors between your practice room in your reality room. And then he said one day you get up from your practice and the walls between your reality room and your practice room have gone away. And your practice is your reality. Audible breath in. The next song we're gonna do, the next thing we're gonna do is kind of sway-y. Yeah, this is the porch of their house. They're actually, yeah. So, yeah, this is the porch of the house. I'm staying here. Good. It's good to know what stage you're at, Shelley. I just for what it's worth, I go from like wide open to completely like my practice becomes an island that I used to visit. Not for very long, but sometimes. All right, so I do want to try to get back into the theme of tonight's class as best I can. Is the sound okay? Are you guys hearing the music all right? I hope the mix is okay. Okay, so for our first exercise, it's going to be... So it's ironic and perfect that I was going to do this exercise to start tonight because it's exactly what would feel great. But our class tonight is on water and wind. Audible breath in. And for our first exercise tonight, we're going to move with our breath. What that means is that I'm going to be conscious. What it means is that I'm going to be conscious of my inhale, and that's going to affect my movement, whatever it is, and then conscious of my exhale. It's hard to do this while talking, so I'll just demo it without talking. Thank you. some of the Maidan. Found a name for a feeling. And they called that feeling the spirit wind. And essentially they believe that meaning and messages was carried in the wind. And that part of its message was how it touched our skin and blew across our bodies. And another part of its message was how it came into our lungs and took out with it what it needed to take and brought in with it what it needed to bring. So their meditation would involve a lot of deep breathing. As if they were taking big breaths in of the now. Hey, Jordan. My hoop in that car. All right, Tiff. Wow, yeah, I had a good sway. I wonder, you guys have been following for so long. I'm sure you can tell when I get lost in my own sway. Because I do. Sometimes I get, you know, it's hard when you're moving to not to not get caught up in the same flow. Okay, I wanted to talk a little bit more about air. And I want to talk about slow motion flight. And what I mean by that is slow motion movement of the hands. One of my favorite Maidan stories is of Darsha and how she would essentially what we would call bend air, how she could sort of bring about storms and dance with clouds and dance with weather. And so for our first exercise, I invite you to try slow motion movement. I love slow motion. And I want you to really think about your hands, the flight of the hands, and of windiness. This is a creative writing flow class tonight. Ever feel this, but I have a feeling you do as flow artist, but sometimes I just feel like I'm out of sync. Like that I'm so focused on something or so distracted by something that I'm not, I can't go with the flow because I don't even know what the flow is. And the hoop has helped me realize when I'm in that state, because it's kind of the same with my hoop. When I think about birds and I think about how they fly and how much time they spend in the air, I can't help but be envious of how well they adjust to the wind. Still get where they're going, even though the wind might be blowing strongly in opposite directions or whirling around them. Audible breath in. About North Carolina is that it's so humid here and it gets so hot that the air gets so thick that you can feel it. And so for an exercise like tonight in this humid ass screen porch that I'm in right now, this exercise is much more visceral. I can actually feel the air. Can you feel it where you are? Fast enough you can. I suppose I'm not in slow motion anymore. Audible breath in. Lost in my own movements right now, I feel so much better. This is what I love about hooping. I feel so much better right now than I did when we started a couple minutes ago. Okay. We're staying with our theme of the hands. Yeah, this will work. Okay, so this exercise might not be perfect for people that get super dizzy. But essentially, our sort of last of the air exercises right now, the wind exercises, are going to be, because we're going to move on to the core, so we're going to start to warm up the body if possible. And if you have the room and the space where you are, and you can do these horizontal, I had other things planned, but the ceiling fans are, my camera makes it look like I'm like 6 feet fucking tall. I'm just in a really small space. Nice. But what I invite you to do is to move the hoop horizontally around you and feel the wind on your hands. You can try stalls if you're the kind that doesn't get dizzy. You can try stalls. But rather than putting your focus on like your hands and what they're doing, see if you can put your focus on the sensation of what they're feeling, like the air that they're actually feeling. Breath in, so we're just about to move into water, so we're going to try to enjoy what's great about air, what's great about wind. For one thing, the hoop is really lightweight. There's no constriction out here in airspace. I can really feel the wind on my hands, like when I'm doing that sort of sticky break back and forth. Actually, that drill is really fun to do if you're feeling for wind on your hands, if you guys remember this guy. I'm keeping my hands open so I can try to feel that air. I can't go vertical, but I can go horizontal in here. Ghosting a hand on top or flying a hand. When you're first learning to hoop, it's like you're waking up the whole body to activate more of it when you're first learning to hoop. Oh. So if I'm doing this move, if I'm a beginner, my hand's probably just chilling here by the side, right? And then as I start to advance and I can split my awareness, then the other hand can move and do cool shit. Those are easy but fun to do. They're kind of like it's a type of pinch. Oops. I'm bringing the hoop across and then ducking my arms in like this. So I'm pinching it like that. So I'm bringing it across, pinch. It's kind of like an outside pinch. Probably easier to do just like one time than do it multiple times, but you can't do it multiple times. Oops.
I call it housework.
All right.
Cause it's light work. What you gonna do? I'ma throw.
Okay, let me take a water break here. Oh man, that sucks about your power, Jackie. Okay. I know that song's going. We probably aren't live on Facebook anyway, so it probably doesn't matter. All right. Let me find a song that I know is not going to get us kicked off of Facebook immediately. Yeah, this will work. Yeah, that'll work. Okay. All right, we're going to move on to The Waste right now. We'll just stay here. Okay, so I'm on The Waste. This is so old school. Okay, so we're gonna go to some old school My Dan teaching here. And so Anaya learns to hoop. She learns to move her body and own it by being taken out to a lake where she, you know, she's this giant child, like physical giant, and she can swirl the water around her. And so it's from this story that, well, from this story anyway, that we're going to talk about water. We're going to imagine that the water we're in right now, the surface of that water is the level of the hoop.
We beat to rap, what key beat to lock, but I'm cool like that. I'm cool like that. I'm cool like that. I'm cool like that. I'm cool like that.
And in a waste current, if you think about hooping the hoop as water and wrapping it around you or splashing it or whatever, it can sort of open up like creative outlets for you to, you know, experience the hoop. Like if I think about a stall, then I'm like turning with this tidal pull thing and it's going to want to go down. Or if I turn against it, it's like, you know, if I've ever been in a boat and, you know, pushed against the current to create a splash.
Man, Cleopatra Jones.
And I'm chill like that. 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 I'm chill.
So the air is still up here, so my hands can still be doing whatever they want it be. Because there's no resistance there. And then the lower body is focused on sort of the resistance of the water or the hoop's rotation.
We get your feet because the clits be fat for us. Them thug the jams and commence to going off. She sweats the beats and asks me because she puffed it.
Me, I got crew kids, seven and a crescent. Us cause a buzz when a nickel bends a dope. Him, that's my man with the asteroid.
Of course, if you've ever been swimming, you know that there's a totally different feeling when you can touch the ground and when you can't touch the ground. So we're in water where we can touch the ground. So we're going to take advantage of that, right? We're going to let our feet push against the ground and push up in through the water.
I'm peace like that. I'm peace like that. I'm peace like that. I'm peace like that. I'm peace.
Check it out, man. I groove like that. I'm smooth like that. I jive like that. I roll like that.
Yeah, I'm thick like that. I stack like that. I'm down like that. I'm black like that.
Yo, I funk like that. I'm fat like that. I'm in like that because I swing like that.
We jazz like that. We freak like that. We zoom like that. We out. We out. We out.
Okay, cool. Okay, I think I'm just going to go with this theme and play songs that I know are going to get us kicked off of Facebook if we're still on there. I don't think we are. Nobody's commenting from Facebook, so we were probably taken down. I hope you're following me on this water metaphor, and I hope I'm delivering it clear. It's like water is beneath everything down here. And then everything above the hoop is going to be air, and no matter what the orientation is. So if I'm shoulder hooping, then most of my body is in water, okay? And in the story of Anaya teaching Anaya, how to hoop, you know, she asked Anaya to keep going deeper and deeper into the water, right? Like deeper, 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 deeper. And then Anaya start to can't, you know, she gets to the point where she can't touch. And then Anaya shouts from the shore. She goes, paddle, 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 paddle. And that's in HoopPath land. That's essentially where the term paddle comes from. And so the idea is that what happened for Anaya was once she got like neck deep, her arms start moving like crazy to keep her to swim. Basically, she's learning to tread water, right? And so it's one way to think about your shoulder hooping. This song is going to get us kicked off totally. All right. I love this track. I hope it doesn't have bad lyrics. I don't think it does. Okay, so we're going to practice some shoulder hooping. It is the Monday night class. You can throw everything off when you start to move them, so just do it in pieces. If you did learn in this kind of like constricted way, just try to breathe intentionally, you know, try to relax. And then eventually, you can start to paddle. And a pulse is basically just like if you imagine sending a wave of water to another kid, that's a pulse.
I'm getting wrong. La 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 la.
If you haven't heard me tell the story of Anaya, I've told it a couple of times in past live streams. But what I like about the story is just how once Anaya, like, owned how big she was, she realized that, like, that bigness, she could create real waves that other people could feel. Like, she could create, like, she could move water, literally. And so she starts to giggle. And in my creative mind, sometimes like just, I always hear her giggling, you know, like with this joy and, you know, this real satisfaction in the ripples that she's creating. Nice, Jordan. Yeah, I'm on the I'm on my brother's screened-in porch because it rained for 3 minutes. This is definitely a different vibe. Hold on 1 second, we'll get some water here. It's really humid here. Okay, if you're wondering, I'm pretending that the end of this class is around 9 o'clock, so since we started at 8. I think we are gonna actually play an old school hip hop song that nobody knows. You'd have to be my age and my kind of nerd to know this one. Yeah, no, it's nice. Andy's wife, my sister-in-law, has a great sense of style, and she's like, they redid all this, I think. Anyway, for what it's worth, my sister-in-law is a therapist, and my brother is a statistician that works in the field of education, trying to make kids smarter. So they're not like, you know, stockbrokers or something. Okay. Actually, yeah. Actually, maybe I'll go with. Yeah. Well, actually, let's go with this one. Okay. So, this water metaphor. I want to do one more shoulder hooping song. I hope you're not too worn out from this, and we'll go ahead and like bring up to the shoulders. Because once you get sort of, and this is going to sound kind of snotty and elitist, but it's just real. Like, once you get advanced enough in your shoulder hooping that you can, once you get advanced enough in your shoulder hooping, you can start to change the focus of what's moving underneath, like what's helping you push on it. And like, you can freeze one arm, you know, or utilize one arm and freeze the other, and you can alternate that. And then what you can also do is open the chest and the back, and to think about like just the rib cage as a source of push. Just the rib cage as a source of push. And this water metaphor can really help with that. So I'm gonna bring on this crazy old school song. You have to be old to even know this one. This was a song that was like big for like 1 year.
1990, Chump Rock jumps upon the scene with the lean and a pocket full of green. The green doesn't symbolize I made it on the top, but RoboCop last year was a shock. The tone of the Popeye cut shook your butt. Kids are screaming, the media says,
okay, but I'm up here.
for you to dance to. The man with the plan.
And what I want you to try to play with, if you feel it, if you're, you know, flowing to it, is putting pulses on it. Hip hop is good for just getting you with the same beat to hit over and over. And I can just try to imagine, or putting my focus on my rib cage, like how is it moving? Like I can try to kind of just not deaden my arms, but just chill them out.
Goes off, you'll smash it, then trash it. You're too young to be plumped in a casket. Just get your boys and bring the noise and just swing it. And for the people, sing it. Kids in the cribs want dibs on the big man. Can he come out? Can he come out and slam a jam? His number one fan, yes I am. All these kids realize that I'm the man. 6'3" and maybe a quarter of an inch bigger than last year, but still a unique figure. Rob Springer, Doc, no Dinky, and Hot Dog know that I'm a man that was born to have a mic on next to me at all times, ready to kick a rhyme that'll keep me out of financial bind. That's why when it comes to fans, I'm never mean. Kids on St. James between Gates and Green always says hello, cause I'm a modest fellow. Never try to play a superstar that's mellow, cause if these kids don't go buy our records, we'll be has-beens and plus naked. So we owe them, so pull out your pen, sign an autograph, you might make a new friend. So just get your boys and bring the noise and just swing it. Now party people in the house, sing it.
One thing you could try is moving with your palms up and palms down. We've done this in a lot of different ways, but with the water metaphor, it can really sometimes help you. My palms are up or out. I'm way externally rotated, or I could bring them in.
Coming back to 1990, Chub Rock jumps upon the scene with a lean and a hardcore dream. The dream wasn't crafted to be pornographic. Decency started from the crib plus kids. Don't need to hear all of that on a rap. The strength of my vibe placed Chubs on the map, cause authority, seniority goes forth me. My staff gives autograph plus give enough laughs. Reap my might, heed my sight. I definitely lead you right to treat me right. Peace.
Nice, Jordan. You guys are cracking me up with this middle-aged stuff. You know, what's so funny is, like, if humans could get out of their own way, like, eventually we'll be living to, like, 140. Like, 40s really will be your 20s. And they'll be looking back at us and, like, in the same way, like, we look back and realize that, like, people used to live to, like, 40. Like, middle age for them was, like, 17 years old. Like, why haven't I succeeded, you know? And so it's funny where we're headed with all this. We're going to live a long time. Assuming we don't kill the earth. We could live a long time, we'll put it that way. Okay. Yeah, 113. Sweet, yeah. I dated a woman whose grandmother died at 113. She's, for a while, she was the oldest living human. Or American, at least, I think. Okay. I forgot. Where are we at on time here? Oh, man, we're almost out of time. Well, maybe we should just sort of free hoop it from here. Yeah. We are. We are going to hoop around. We're going to do point technique. That's what it's all built about. I used to have a whole story about point technique and where it came from was because I just saw, like, what are we going to do in our 90s? We're going to need to be, you know, moving slowly and smiling at 6 a.m. in the morning. I used to make the joke, it's like some when goth comes back in 2040, or when it resurges, or some goth teen at like 5:30 in the morning heading home hoping her parents won't bust her. She's going to see all these 90-year-olds smiling in the park. And it'll be us doing point technique. All right, let's just free hoop from here, I think. Yeah, I think I'm kind of feeling this sort of hip-hop vibe. So we'll do a little free hoop and then we'll sort of call it a night.
Baby,
keep on moving. Probably try to slow it down. Play this one. There's one kind of weird line, but it's not. It's just dirty. Anyway, this is the Free Hoop guys. Thank you for joining me. We will be back Thursday. Thursday we're gonna do a Zoom class. Even if it rains, I'll do it from in here. But we're gonna do a Zoom class. So if you wanna join us, do a Zoom class. We're gonna be able to do it a regular class and then a separate Zoom thing because my brother's internet's awesome. So you can choose to join any way you want. It'll be happening simultaneously.
Ready for this type. Now I rock hip, everybody's rocking hype. On the baby down low, you might see me at a show. If the show ain't for dope, then you won't. She's a bro. The grand man just as usual. But let me slow down, cause I know I'm confusing y'all.
This is the weirdest way. I love being grounded at the ceiling.
Yeah.
Thank you, Lindsay.
I never hit skid. Never date a girl if the girl got a kid. Nah, Papa's got a brand new bag. And I never hit skins once they sag. God says groovy, me like see a movie. Stick it in easy, it comes back breezy. First to tell you slow down, but be the second to take you uptown. I won't fall or fumble, trip dagger or stumble. Not a soft sucker, but I still come humble. The next candidate who holds all the weight, it ain't you better get the story straight. Ron Stud is my DJ, makes the girl feel like it's foreplay. Coming like a bull, so you better yell ole. Here is the one, I shine like the sun. You get there close, you might get done. Yeah.
Okay, guys. Thank you, Carla. Thank you, John. Thank you, Jackie. Lindsay, Carla.
The bass player's real, the drummer's real.
To everyone that's been here tonight, I really appreciate it. I'm sure I'm forgetting somebody, but thank you guys so much. We're going to do one more song and call it a night. I'm imagining most of you are dipping out now, so thank you, thank you, thank you. We will be back Thursday. Rain or shine, we'll be back Thursday at 7. We're going to do a Zoom class, so get your space ready if you want to do it. This will be our last song.
Unexpected. Multi-dimensional. I'm a listener. Unexpected sound. Refugee all stars. Sweetest thing I've ever known was like the kiss on a collarbone, the soft caress of happiness. The way you wore your style of dress, I wish I didn't get so weak. Oh, ooh, baby. Just to hear you speak makes me argue just to see how much you're in love with me. See, like a queen, a queen.
walk away.
Don't walk away.
So I tell you leave when I mean stay. Warm as the sun.